Nurturing Neighbourhoods Walk and Workshop. Snowing, and it's the end of October. Snowing. Anyway, we're at Gore Meadows, which is in Brampton. And why are we here again?
It's a nurturing, it's a walk and drive through in our neighborhood. It's a plan for 2040 Brampton.
Apparently, this
area has been designated as one of the ones that they're going to work on. Because right now, there's nothing around here.
True. Nothing. I don't even know if I'll be alive in 2040. Halloween's a week away. Less than a week. Record these things just, you know, in case you're wondering. Is that like a YouTube channel for Brampton?
Nice. I appreciate it, because last time we had a Neighbourhood Watch Brampton recording it.
Oh yeah?
They weren't able to come with us today.
You like Don or Fazzle or?
Both.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is technically where our first stop would be. We're just going to go over a little bit of history about the whole Gore area where we just drove by. Originally in 1819, Gore area was known as the Toronto Gore Township.
I think because I used to be the heritage coordinator, it's in me that made me want to say something, but the McBean Barn also has Farm Start, a program for farmers looking for smaller plots of land to grow food, and there is a farm-to-table movement there, so you can access fresh food for you and your families. And what we also want to consider is spots for community gardens. Is there a desire for people to have community plots to grow their own food? Maybe not for themselves, maybe to contribute to our local food banks. We have had that start in Brampton. So think about all those things as we walk through these neighborhoods and opportunities for that to happen, and to meet your neighbors, to contribute to the greater societal good, and to use space in more ways, right? For co-benefits, different purposes. Sorry.
So the Ebenezer Community Hall, or former Ebenezer Schoolhouse, was built as a union school serving boundaries between Toronto Gore and Vaughan. We have an historic plaque here. Much of what I will be saying will be listed on this plaque as well.
So one thing that we definitely want to have you thinking about is, what are some things that can contribute to a housing community? Do people want more bike lanes? Do people think that there aren't enough? Because as far as I know, there are about 12 designated bus lanes or bike lanes in the city, and does that fairly represent our biking population? How many people actually want a bike? An interesting fact, that's what I'm saying.
Building aren't serving the purpose. walk too.
Places to walk too. They're important and essential.
There right now I've got two gas stations. So you know, I go get a pop or a chocolate.
Typically in inner neighborhoods as well.
Good opportunity to ask any questions that you didn't get to ask, or maybe bring anything to our attention as well. Okay?
So that was different than I thought it would be. It was more of a city planning thing than it was a neighborhood watch thing, where they kind of took us on the tour. We went to different areas. We met some people on the Vision 2040 team and different members of Brampton Works, I guess you would say. And it was enjoyable. So I'm going to try and do more videos that are Brampton positive. So if you find it interesting, just leave a like, comment, and we'll see what happens. So thanks for watching.